I had a dream about a bear that was very powerful. I had started a conservation organization to get the grizzly bear listed as a threatened species in Alberta, which is where I lived. But I was, you know, stressed, overworked, you know, felt like I was doing too much. And I was thinking, oh, I gotta stop doing the volunteer grizzly bear conservation stuff. I'm running out of energy. One night I had this really vivid dream. I was up at the top of a basin in the mountains, and the grizzly bear was walking along through the fog towards me, just this visceral experience with this ghost-like animal. And it came close enough to me to whisper, like, don't stop, don't stop. And so I told that story to a Native American man that I knew. His name was Levi Holt from the Nez Perce tribe in Idaho. And he's like, that bear's telling you not to give up. So I didn't, and we got the bears listed as threatened. Yeah.
You know, Jeff came to us with extensive on-the-ground experience as an advocate. And for him, it was really working on his writing intensively. And the ability to tap that creative side here and work with people in creative writing in the English department and work with the folks that we have here in the Environmental Studies program together, and that's made him all the more powerful of a writer. And so he's published that Grizzly Manifesto book and gone on to be a really kind of a leading journalist. So it's been really fun to watch his career develop after his graduation from our graduate program.
No, I'm very much in awe of the grizzly bear. It's amazing that they're recovering and that they are, you know, utilizing the landscape.
The grizzly bear for the tribal people have a very significant spiritual role in their creation stories. It was never hunted or harassed. It was always considered a good omen when you got to see a grizzly bear.
Hush my troubled mind and rest. I need to breathe and clear my head. Shut my eyes and dream of things I could have done much differently.
Carrie is amazing. And so Carrie is trying to address things more from a, you know, how do we live with grizzlies? Grizzly bears can go from passive to aggressive fast. And so if they decide to, you know, be angry with something, they're convincing.
I told you once, I'll tell you twice. You have my heart until I die.
It's Jungian in that sense, right? The shadow side, the you know, beautiful and dark at the same time. Kind of like life.
Yeah.
Coming here to do your graduate studies about grizzly bears or any other wildlife species is just an enormous opportunity. You're where the big mammals are. You have access to nature that's relatively unspoiled. You have access to long native traditions that are richly embedded in the story of the bear and other wildlife. You have a vital writing community that is here to express all those values, and you have a terrific research faculty across social sciences, humanities, and the natural sciences that can take on any facet you'd like to study of grizzly bear wildlife.
there are so many ways of understanding and trying to work with the natural world that didn't exist 10 years ago, 20 years ago. With animals like grizzlies, they're forcing us to be effective when we apply these tools and when we make these decisions, because we don't want to get it wrong.